Hi friends, I'm Yamini Sharma and I welcome you back to my channel, The Saffron Box. Today in this video, I'm going to be talking about the month of February 2021, which is a very, very special month in the entire year. Out of the entire 12 months, this month is going to be special because it is going to show you a rare phenomena astrologically, which will happen on the 11th of February. Now, I'm talking about a major planetary conjunction wherein, apart from three planets, all the other planets are going to be conjunct in the sign of Capricorn. Now, the last time this conjunction happened within the sign of Capricorn was in 1962. So, the 4th of February, the same month, 4th of February 1962, we saw this conjunction, and exactly 59 years later, 59 years and a week later, we see all the planets, six planets getting together in the sign of Capricorn. Now, if I take into count Pluto as well, then it makes it seven. So, you have Sun, you have Moon, Jupiter, Saturn, Mercury, Venus, and if we have to take Pluto, we can take Pluto also. So that makes it seven planets in the sign of Capricorn. And if I just talk about Vedic astrology, it still talks about six planets in the sign of Capricorn, and it just leaves out Mars, which is currently in its own sign of Aries. Mars is going to be moving out of Aries around the 22nd of February. And on the 22nd, once it moves out into the sign of Taurus, where we already have Rahu. So Mars and Rahu are going to get conjunct again over there, which is again a very, very powerful conjunction. Then we have Ketu in the sign of Scorpio. So you can check out my video on the Rahu Ketu transit also, which I had made a few months back. And apart from this, all the planets are going to be in the sign of Capricorn. You can check the description box wherein I have actually mentioned the transit dates, the dates of combustion of all the planets also. So all in all, this month is going to bring in a lot of focus on the sign of Capricorn, because you know, if you see, Capricorn is going to be fully activated. Now, whether it's going to be positive or negative activation, that depends on how your chart is, what your natal promise is, what kind of dasha are you undergoing. But there is going to be a lot of focus or a lot of action wherever the sign of Capricorn is in your birth chart. So keep in mind as to where the sign of Capricorn falls in your birth chart, check your ascendant, and you can check the results accordingly. Also, one more thing which I would like to add over here is that the Artha trine is fully activated. So when I talk about the Artha trine, I'm talking about the 2nd, 6th and the 10th signs, okay, as per the natural horoscope. So the 2nd sign, that is Taurus, has Mars and Rahu by the 3rd week of the month. Then in the 6th, in the 6th house, that is in the sign of Virgo, you know, Virgo gets the impact, Virgo gets the aspect of Rahu, the aspect of Jupiter from the 10th house. The 10th house, which is the highest Artha trine, has all the other planets. So I have talked about Mars, Rahu and Ketu, and all the other planets, six of them, are in the sign of Capricorn. Now, Capricorn, we know, is the sign of karma. It is the natural karmasthan in the horoscope. And it is a sign which is owned by Saturn. So, all this is going to be happening in the realm of Saturn. There is going to be a combustion of Mercury and Venus also. Mercury and Venus both get very close to the Sun also this month. And then Sun and Venus crossover by the middle of the month, by the 13th, onto the next sign, that is Aquarius. So we see Sun and Venus breaking out of this conjunction by the middle of the month, but the 11th of Feb actually sees action happening, actually sees all these planets together. So important event, and I would point out that Mercury is going to be very close. Mercury is going to be retrograde also in motion most of the month. So please do check your communication, your oral word, your written word. How are you communicating? Because whenever Mercury is retrograde and this kind of a conjunction is taking place, because Mercury is also going to be part of this conjunction, there are chances that whatever you say does not get understood by the other party. Communication does not get complete. It is complete only when what you said is understood by the other party. The information gets, moves and is received as it is. So this does not happen. There are problems here. Also, Venus is also part of this conjunction, and Venus gets combust also. So Venus is something which Venus as a planet, signifies love, signifies relationships, signifies your wife. It is important that you take care of your marriage, take care of your relationships this month, because Venus getting combust could trigger in some problems over here as well. So though spiritually, I would say whenever these planets are getting close to the sun, this is a wonderful opportunity to look inwards, to let go. Sun is the king of planets, and planets, all planets coming close to the sun actually gives an opportunity to get purified, So there's an element of sattva here, which we are talking about as well. So look inwards this month, especially for certain signs, which I'm going to mention as I go about sign wise. Look inwards. Try to observe more and then react. This is a time for deliberate and thought over action. It's not a time period. It's not a month to be impulsive and rash sometimes, if I may use the word. Right? So I'll go about with all the 12 signs, and I'll begin with Aries. Aries sees major changes at workplace. This entire major conjunction happens in the 10th house. Your second house is activated when Mars, which is currently in your first house in the ascendant, moves out onto the second. So this month you begin by feeling very confident, by, you start with an upstart. You feel like you could take on everything. You could take on a lot of responsibility. But be a little careful, because this could fizzle out a little, or you could feel that, yes, I've taken up so much, but how do I go about it? You could, end up in a little tricky situation also later on as the month goes by. So just be very, very careful about what you shoulder. What kind of responsibility are we talking about here? And be ready for any kind of changes at your work. So I would suggest that you bite only as much as you can chew. Do not bite more than what you can actually handle. So there are changes indicated at workplace. There could be change in your boss or somewhere in the higher up line. So something which impacts you though. So your boss or your super boss, there could be a change. There could be a change in relationship over here as well. Those of you who are seeking a change in your job could also, find the change this month, especially around the middle of the month. So you have to be a little careful though with regards to your communication and how your written work is going up and understood by others. So check and recheck whatever is going out of your hands. Whatever leaves your table. And for those who are studying, students, or those who are making a choice of subjects, you are at a threshold of making choice of subjects or going in for higher studies, this is time where you could feel a lot of confusion creeping in. And I think it's best to seek proper guidance, professional guidance, to move ahead. So there are chances that you dealing with a lot of major money matters. So be careful over there, and also avoid any kind of clash in your family matters. So whatever you feel, whatever you want to say, say it with a lot of calmness and Do not say anything more than what is required. I think that is a word of caution for Aries ascendant. Then we move on to the next sign, that is Taurus. So for Taurus, you know, your Lagnesh comes to the ninth house, where this major conjunction is taking place, that is Venus, Lagnesh's Venus. And in the ninth house, this entire conjunction actually makes you focus on matters related to higher studies, matters related to your ideology, your higher thinking, what your ideas are actually, higher ideas about life, your wisdom. So this could actually make those of you who are studying focus a lot on your studies. This could actually, you know, put some cracks with your relationship with respect to the institution where you're studying, or the gurus or the teachers whom you're dealing with. So be very careful about how you're dealing with people around you, especially seniors, you know, those who are teaching you. So there could be a clash there. There could be unnecessary arguments which could actually land you in some trouble. So be careful there. With respect to your relationship with your father, now you could see certain ideological differences, right? So whatever age you may be, there could be differences with your father-like figures in the house, elders in the house. So you have to make sure that whatever idea you put through in a acceptable manner, and don't be rash. So that is something which I would really advise against. Your fourth lord, Sun, is in the middle of the entire conjunction. So family matters, matters related to your domestic peace, you know, domestic matters, property issues, could be a cause of differences between you and your elders, you and your father. In fact, this is a time to be very careful about your mother's health and father's health also. So this is a time to be responsible and make sure that whatever you're doing does not, you know, it holds you in good stead in the long term. So think futuristic, think about the future, and do not get involved in petty things around you. This is also a good time to listen to your spouse. You get ample support from your spouse in the second half of the month. So listen in to your spouse, understand what he or she is saying, and take in good advice. Be receptive towards advice. Professionally, the second half of the month seems to be good, seems to be getting you into gains, as you know, Sun and Venus both move into the 10th house, and this conjunction breaks somehow. So Sun aspects its own house, that is the 4th, and Lagnesh Venus also comes out and comes to the 10th. So you get into more fruitful action by the second half of the month. Then we look at the next ascendant, that is Gemini. Now for Gemini, if you see your 8th house is fully activated, full of action. 8th house, which has Capricorn, has all the, you know, this major planetary conjunction happening here. Lagnesh Mercury also joins in. And your 7th lord, 4th lord of course is Mercury. So the Kendra lords, that is Mercury and Jupiter, are involved in this conjunction. And the trine lords, that is Venus and Saturn, are also here in this conjunction. So imagine, I mean, this is like saying that everything around you is actually in the 8th house. So this brings in about a lot of transformation. This is a time to keep your mind open, keep your subconscious open towards more changes. So some of you could actually feel changes happening physically around you, and some of you could go through some mental or emotional changes also. So this is a time to be receptive and go with the flow. I think that is what is important. There could be some health problems which could crop up by the first or the second week. So be careful over there. Any kind of carelessness while driving should be avoided. So drive carefully. There could be some hidden matters which you could come into. Now, when I talk about hidden matters, matters like inheritance is hidden. You know, till the time you come into that inheritance, it is a hidden matter. It is a closed matter. So inheritance matters could crop up. Inheritance issues could take away your time. You could come into some deep secrets which you have not, which you had never thought about that you would deal with. So there could be some hidden issues, some secrets which you could come into. Those of you who are into research, who are into higher research, pursuing their PhDs, etc., and certain things, could actually make use of this time, because you could actually come across matters which are hidden, which come out in the open, and you benefit from it. So those of you who are in the financial sector could also see some changes at workplace. Then we move on to the next sign, that is Cancer. So for Cancer, if you see the Kendra house, that is the seventh house, contains this major planetary conjunction. And for you also, the ascendant lord, that is Moon, is part of this conjunction, is part of the Amavasya, which is happening, because when Moon and Sun, as I said, come to the same degrees, that is when the exact time of Amavasya happens, that is when the Amavasya or the new moon takes place. So it is going to be a little challenging time dealing with your emotions, because Moon comes into the seventh house, goes over all these planets there, you know, Jupiter, Saturn, Sun. So Moon being a soft planet, you know, sometimes this could happen that you find it difficult to contain yourself emotionally. So certain matters could actually break you down into some emotional outbursts. So that totally depends, of course, on how your natal chart is, what kind of dasha you're going into, and how are you exactly, how strong of a person are you actually. So a lot of factors are there. We cannot just put this all on a transit as such. That is something which I always say in my videos. So the seventh house being so activated, there could be challenge in relationships. There could be changes in your business. So regarding your partnerships, etc., there could be some changes. You could take some major decisions which affect your business or your partnership. So do that with a lot of deliberate thought. This is also a good month for those in studies, because your fifth lord, that is Mars, is out of this conjunction and in the 10th house, bold enough, and then moves on to the 11th. So those of you who are looking at any gains from speculation, like stock markets or mutual funds, any kind of a thing where you use your luck actually, could see some benefit. So this could happen by the third week of February. This is also a time to be very careful about your public image. So many planets in the seventh could actually bring in some changes to your public image. So make sure that whatever you're doing, howsoever you're conducting yourself, is pleasant to other people. So this could bring in a lot of other people putting in or chipping in their opinions about you. So you'll have to be on your guard around this time when the Amavasya takes place. Overall, this is a good month for gains. Mars and Rahu together in the 11th, two malefics though, but in the 11th house at least activate and bring in some gains. Then we have Leo. Now when we talk about Leo, see, the Lagnesh Sun is in the sixth house, in the middle of this conjunction, and Mercury, Venus come close, Moon comes close. So there is a lot of hard work on the cards. There's a lot of, growth indicated, for which you'll have to do a lot of hard work. So this is Upchay Bhav, the sixth house, and so many planets over here actually trigger in something which pushes you to achieve more. So this kind of a planetary movement actually, pushes even the laziest of all of us into some action. So some action, wherever it is required, whether at workplace or your daily routine or towards yourself, towards your health and fitness, you know, we'll be compelled to take some action. We'll be compelled to wake up and pull up our socks. So this first half could be a little unsettling. You know, whenever we get into a new routine or something new is happening around us, a new changes are never easy. So we'll take in some time. Leo ascendant will take in some time to kind of go through this. But the second half will be a little better. So you need to be a little flexible in your mindset, and just not hold on to any kind of a rigidity or any kind of a false ego or false pride. So this is a time when Sun actually comes close to Saturn also this month, and this could bring in confrontational scenes. But this is a time to let go of your ego and kind of listen to other people, what they're saying. Sometimes it is like, you know, listening to your to the help in your house also. So maintain a humble attitude and be open to learning around you. Take care of your health, because so many planets in the sixth house are not good. You might take some initiative, but you might overwork yourself as well. There could be issues at workplace which also could require your attention. So we move on to Virgo, which is the next sign. So for Virgo, we see that your Lagnesh Mercury is in the fifth house, in the middle of this entire planetary conjunction. So it shows us very many important things getting affected. One, any kind of a problem you get into, you find difficulty finding a creative solution to it. And we all know that a lot of problems require out-of-the-box thinking, require creative thinking. So this month, you find yourself a little, handicapped when it comes to problem solving. Your fifth house is actually getting jammed. So the first half of the month could be a little challenging. Second half gets a little better. Those of you who are studying could have a little tough time the first half of the month. People who have grown-up children could actually have clashes or some kind of disagreements with their grown-up children. So there could be arguments, disagreements, and children actually take up a lot of your time and effort. So this is a time to avoid any conflict with your teachers, with your guru-like figures, because if you see, the fifth house has this planetary conjunction, and the ninth house also has Mars and Rahu conjunction by the end of the month. Mars is in the eighth house for about 20-21 days in the entire month, and then it moves on to the ninth house. So it's time to avoid any kind of a conflict and be very careful if you're traveling overseas or traveling long distance. So for Virgo, that was that. We move on to the next sign, which is Libra. Now for Libra, if you see, the Lagnesh is also part of this conjunction, major conjunction in the fourth house of your horoscope. So your fourth house sees this sixth planet conjunction, and then you have Mars sitting very strong in the seventh house in its own sign, and then it moves on to the eighth house and joins Rahu. So all this, what does it mean? It shows that there's a lot of chances for disputes or some kind of issues with your spouse, with other people. So this month you actually have to be very, very careful with regards to your relationships, because first, if you begin with your spouse only, you know, Mars is sitting strong in the seventh, and then thereafter also there's a malefic influence. So there could be disagreements, there could be discord. And those of you who are anyways undergoing a troubled marriage, or the dasha which you're undergoing is not too good, could face in some major issues over here. So be very careful there. Land and property issues will take up a lot of your time. So you could think of investments, you could think of managing your property. There could also be a lot of focus on buying a vehicle or selling your vehicle. So buying, selling, land, houses or vehicles. These three things take up a lot of your time. Domestic matters take up a lot of your time. It is also a good time to consolidate things around you. Because professionally, even, you know, how much ever you want, focus may not be there. You know, you'll have to focus on domestic issues. This entire month is such, especially the first half. The second half of the month could actually make you travel. There are strong chances of travel, but you have to be careful while traveling because Mars and Rahu together in the 8th are not a very bright sign. So you have to be careful about on the road. Or anything, you know, which could suddenly happen adversely towards you. Then we move on to the next sign, which is Scorpio. So for Scorpio, you know, your third house has this planetary conjunction, major planetary conjunction with Sun, Jupiter, Saturn, Mercury, Venus, and then Moon joining in. And the first half is pretty active, and thereafter Sun and Venus come out of this conjunction, move on to the fourth house. So we also have Mars moving out from your 6th to the 7th house. So actually, if you see the 3rd and the 6th houses, that are, these are the Upachaya Bhavas, the growth houses are actually pretty activated. So make sure that you take action, take initiative towards whatever you want to do. This is a time to take up new endeavors, but be very thoughtful, be very, very mindful about what you're going to do, because I have seen that when so many planets come over to the Upachaya Bhavas, people take up a lot of projects, but they are not able to sustain all this, they are not able to carry through whatever work they take up. So be very, very mindful about what you're taking up, what kind of responsibility are you shouldering, because you'll have to take all this long term. So new ideas could come in, you could contact new people and there'll be an overflow of new ideas. The third house is actually superbly activated. And this, while all this is happening, do not ignore your relationships. That's very important. Venus has to be taken care of. Your spouse has to be taken care of, especially for male natives. So do not ignore your relationships. Especially your spouse, because this could actually be a little problematic. Deal with your spouse properly. Avoid any aggression or conflict with your spouse. That could actually disturb your peace of mind. Then we move on to the next sign, that is Sagittarius. So for Sagittarius, you see the second house is pretty activated. And then the sixth house also will see Mars and Rahu conjunction by the 22nd. So the Artha trine is again activated. So for all the fire signs, actually the Artha trine is activated. So there's a focus, a lot of focus on money matters, on family issues. This also shows disturbance or conflicts within the family. So see what you can handle and see what you cannot handle. So you'll have to, there'll be a lot of challenges coming up your way when it comes to handling money as well as family matters. So have to be careful there. Your communication could actually cause some ups and downs in your relationships. So you have to be very careful about how you're communicating. So keep your words in check. That is very important. Travels are indicated. Sun and Venus both move on to the third house by the second half of the month. So you could see yourself traveling. Some of you could actually see long distance travel as well, because Sun aspects its own house, the ninth house as well. So they could be traveling, they could be socializing. Those of you who have not been able to get enough time with their relatives, spend time with relatives, spend time with their spouses. So a better half, a better second half is coming up. though there are chances for some kind of a litigation issue or legal matter also coming up this month, as soon as Mars and Rahu both combine in the sixth house. So you could actually go all guns blazing at your opposition. This, you know, Mars and Rahu, especially for a fiery sign, this is a deadly combination, I would say. So you could actually, you know, go with all zeal to overcome your opposition, overcome anybody who's standing opposite and who's not, you know, who's actually opposing you, opposing your ideas. So make sure that whatever you're doing, you are being a little mindful about what are the practical implications of whatever you're doing. So do not be impulsive. Mars and Rahu conjunction over here can actually make you act in impulse, which you need to avoid against. So the second half is a little better. Second half is also better for relationships and for socializing as well. Then we move on to the next sign, that is Capricorn. For Capricorn, if you actually see all this six planet conjunction is happening in the first house, and especially, you know, on the day of the exact Amavasya, the 11th of Feb, when all the planets are together, the seventh lord is also there, that is Moon. So this is a time where you know, your relationships with others could be a focal point. And how are you dealing with relationships? How are you dealing with everything happening around you? This shows a lot of mental activity, a lot of new ideas, new people, a lot of influence of your spouse, of your family, of your friend circle, a lot of activity around you, but sometimes you may not understand what to filter in and what to filter out. So this is a time to observe everything and maintain your inner peace and calm. Observe everything and then, you know, take in your decisions. So you'll find a lot of push from quarters around you, as in from your family, from your friend circle, etc., to push to act towards something, towards making, you know, going towards a new venture, putting some new idea into action. But I think this is a time to actually evaluate everything, listen to everybody, but actually then by the end of it, listen to what you want to do. This is a very good time to look inwards, especially with Sun and Moon coming together on the 11th. Time to look inwards, maybe some meditation practice will help. Control your thoughts, or rather I would say controlling thoughts is not so easy. Manage your thoughts, that is a more appropriate way of putting it. So manage your thoughts and maintain your inner balance. That is very important for Capricorn ascendant. So moving on to the next sign, which is Aquarius. For Aquarius, I see that the 12th house has the major planetary conjunctions happening. Mars is in the third and moves on to the fourth, joins up with Rahu by the 22nd of the month. So Sun and Venus also come out, and they come to the ascendant, that is the first house, by the second half of the month. So the first part is something which I see as a little disturbing part of the month, especially with the Lagnesh also being there and so many planets crossing over, so many planets getting conjunct there. So those of you who are suffering through any health issue, please be very, very careful. Get into timely medical checkups. Take care of your health. There could be expenditure of there could be expenditure towards your health, towards checkups. So that's a major reason for you to take care of your health, because anything which you ignore now could actually become a bigger problem later. Mars is in the third. You could actually deal up with any adversity, any kind of issues, whether it is health issue or any other issue, with a lot of courage, with a lot of bravery, I would say, as such. But make sure that all the aggression or all the go which Mars gives you is contained outside. You know, you deal with all this outside your house, outside the domestic periphery. Because when Mars and Rahu both combine in the fourth house, this could actually give in a lot of chances wherein your domestic peace could actually get disturbed. So Mars and Rahu together could cause in ups and downs within the family members or within your relatives at home, etc. So be a little mindful over there. Those of you who are in some kind of business, this could be a good month, especially as soon as the second half of February starts off, because you could do well there. Those looking at some improvement in their marriage, in their relationships. Why I talk about marriage and relationships is because majority of the people are facing problems in relationships only. Money is not a very big problem, relationships certainly is. So, those of you who have any problems in terms of their marriage, relationships there with spouse, etc., I think the second half of the month could actually make you work towards your spouse, make you work towards your marriage. Then we move on to the last sign of the zodiac, that is Pisces. So if you have a Pisces ascendant, you have these planetary conjunctions, all these planets coming up together in the 11th house. And as many planets as you have in the 11th house is good for you. That is what it is. That is what is said though. But a lot depends on what your natal chart has, what the natal chart is promising you, what kind of a dasha are you undergoing. So if you're undergoing a Shani dasha, the results will be different. If you're undergoing a Mars dasha, the results will obviously be different. But we see that Mars is in the second house the majority of the month. Then Rahu, Mars and Rahu come together by the 22nd. And this is a time when there'll be a lot of activity, a lot of initiative you will take towards social activities, towards being very ambitious, towards gaining whatever you want. So you get a little restless here, especially by the second half. As soon as Mars and Rahu both come together, you feel very restless. You really, you feel that no time should be lost and your goals should be achieved. So this is a time to be a little patient, because this entire planetary conjunction is actually governed by Saturn. It's happening in Saturn's sign. So whatever is going to be happening is going to be under the realm of Saturn here. So do not make haste. The second half of the month actually sees Sun and Venus coming out of this conjunction. So this shows that there are various indications. Now, those of you who are looking at higher studies could get a chance, could get some more clarity. This month also is a little difficult in terms of your marriage, in terms of your relationship with your spouse. So you have to be careful there. There could be, you or your partner, one of the two, could actually be a little overambitious. Could actually feel restless, because of which the other also feels restless. So be practical about what to expect and how to go about it. So that is the key for Pisces ascendant for this entire month, right? So gains are going to come, they might be a little slow, and you have to be practical and little realistic about what your ambitions are and what you can finally realize. Yeah. So thank you. I'll close here and see you soon in my next video.